Standing at the Beam was commissioned by the Edward D. Anderson Choral Scholars Fund, and I would like to take just a moment to acknowledge and thank the family of Edward D. Anderson for making this piece and this performance possible. Now it's my pleasure to introduce the composer, Andrea Clearfield, and the poet, Anthony Silvestri, to say a few words about the piece.
Thank you so much, David. I feel so honored and humbled to have been asked to write this piece. When I was offered this commission to write a piece that could serve as a source of healing for survivors and for the MSU campus, I had to ask myself, could I really do this? And I spent some time doing some soul searching about that. And when I came up with the yes was because I believe so strongly in the transformative power of music, and I wanted to create something meaningful. That process took 2 years, some of it written during lockdown, and it began with the choice of the poet. And I thought of Tony Silvestri first. His piece, The Sacred Veil, was how I met him in 2019, that premiere of that piece with composer Eric Whitaker. And it was a piece about the death of his wife. And he created a text that was so moving about pain and loss that moved to the possibility of healing and love. And I just found it so effective, the way that it could relate to all of us. And so I thought that Tony would be the perfect person to write this text, also that he specializes in writing for the singing voice and knows how to make these words sing. So when I asked Tony, and he accepted, I asked him if he would consider the idea of referencing the balance beam, and that the piece could move from imbalance to balance and from brokenness to wholeness. So I'm going to turn things over to Tony. He's going to tell you a little bit about his process, and then I'll just finish by giving you some things to listen for in the music.
I too was deeply honored by the gift of being able to write this piece, and I wanted to lend my voice to this process of healing and to stand in solidarity with these brave survivors. The central motive of the poem is this idea of the balance beam. Now that's a symbolic, certainly of gymnasts, but I wanted it to stand as a metaphor for all who have to perform in the midst of storms inside. Part of the poem is this balancing across the beam of an internal and an external voice. So this central metaphor of standing at the beam became the sort of my way in to talking about the routine that goes across the beam from brokenness to wholeness, from pain to healing. And ultimately from acting alone, from solitude to togetherness and solidarity. These were the themes that I was working towards in writing this text, and then handed it over to Andrea for her artistry.
Thank you, Tony. Just a few things to listen for, because it is a new piece of music. The first thing that you'll hear is one note played by the first violin by itself, and then another note played alone. To me, that represented the word stand, first, the beginning of the first word of the text. Then two notes, standing. Then you'll hear three notes, bum, 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 at the beam. So the text drives the piece, and the strings set it up. I was asked what kind of ensemble I would like to have for this piece, and I chose the string quintet for several reasons. One is that the instruments are made out of wood, and there was a reference to the balance beam, and that they could play percussively as well as lyrically, and they could make sounds with the wood of the bow or knocking on the instrument. The string ensemble isn't playing in a Brahmsian manner. You're not going to hear them featured in such a way as you might in other chamber music. They provide the texture and the background and the commentary for the words to really shine. The piece moves from that one single note alone to the very end of the piece, and the last word that you hear is together. So it's a trajectory of moving from alone to together. There's another theme I wanted to point out, and that is, I can't balance alone, which is an important line in the text, inviting community support. And you'll hear that in a canon. I can't balance alone, I can't balance alone. And it's sung, to me, that was like the circle of an embracing community. And you'll hear it in the choir, and then at the very end, you'll hear it in the high strings. And underneath that, you'll hear the standing at the beam in the low strings. And right in the middle, you'll hear the choir singing, we stand at the beam together. We stand with you. Thank you.
All alone, Standing at the